Hi there, YouTube. Okay, so what you're looking at right here is the screen to my little Frankenlab's experimental unit here. And what we're going to do is we're going to take you on a little journey from the basic system up and through all kinds of different development. So what we have to start with is this. It's the simplified controller, which looks just like this. It's got some functionality. When I turn it on, you notice that all this becomes active. I can hit home, and it will go through a homing routine, which will automatically detect some magnets that are placed in the unit, and it's going to find those magnets, move off of them, and come back to them and mark that spot. So at that point, it knows exactly where it is. Okay? And you'll notice now that the X, Y, and Z are now homed. Okay? That's great, and it's got some other functionality. I can change the spindle speed, I can change the jog speed, and I can, you know, move the unit around. Alright? That's fine and dandy. This is what we're going to start with. Now let me show you what we're going to get to. This is the Frankenlab's version 1.2. I've made some revisions, and I want to bring you up to speed on it. So, first off, brand new splash screen. Next, we come in, and you notice there's all kinds of goodies over here. You see this indicator? That lets me know that it's currently not active. Watch what happens when I turn the machine on. That gives me an indication that everything's active right now. Again, I have the ability to home everything, and it'll use the same magnets, and so it'll actually end up in the same location. But that's where the similarity ends. At that point, we've got a lot of new features. So, yes, I can use these to move the X, Y, and Z around, but now I've added these nice big buttons here, which are very easy to use. And I can change the feed rate. Go to the right, and let's say that's where we want our home position to be. Now, we've got that saved. I can click on this, and you notice it sets everything to zero. But you also notice that the Z-axis is not actually touching the base. Here's a cool trick. Watch this. I made a little touch plate, and this is temporary. This will get replaced. I can put this in here, and it can detect contact changes. See? And so we're going to put this in here, clip this on, and now I've got a routine that when I click on it, it'll automatically bring it down, find the surface of the plate, pop up a little bit, and come down real slow. And now it's set exactly. So I can take this plate off, and now when I tell this thing to go home, it goes up, it clears out of the way, and comes back down. And if you'll notice, it is exactly on the tabletop. So very, very handy. I've got some other routines on here. I've got automated peck drilling routines and bolt hole circles, and I've got tabs that we're going to fill with even more stuff. So we're going to get started. We'll take baby steps. We'll get the machine dialed in, and then I'll show you how to build out the panel. I don't know how many sequences or how many videos we're going to have in this series, but we'll get there. So anyway, stay tuned. Let's have some fun.